Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen. Now, the Lord has spoken with me about the mission that is coming up in Namibia. And in that conversation, the Lord has shown me a lot of immorality in Namibia. And he took me to this particular community in the village where one man has many wives, some of them young wives, others old. And I can see a small hill, and the Lord makes him show me a bit of his land. See, he has all this land. He has built for each wife a small house. There's a lot of polygamy. There's a lot of sexual immorality in Namibia. And the Lord has now brought this to my attention as I prepare to leave for that country. Sexual immorality. I see this particular community that caught the attention of the Lord, where they have many wives, and they have built huts in a row, in a line for the wives. One wife is an elder wife, and then the next neighbor, I see the Lord as he takes me to tour this land of Namibia. I see the witchcraft. I now see people doing witchcraft. They are dressed in traditional clothes, a little bit not well clothes. Yeah, almost naked, but dancing. They are men and women. They are dancing in a certain way, raising their hands up like this and shaking their shoulders like this, as they are doing witchcraft in Namibia. So the Lord is sending me to Namibia with a very stern message of repentance. He has already brought to his own attention and brought to my attention the sexual sin that is in that land, polygamy, the marrying of many wives in the villages. And then I see witchcraft. I see a lot of witchcraft. The Lord makes me walk there, and he allows those people. He makes them talk to me without knowing they're talking to me. They describe to me everything they do, the immorality, the many wives, and the witchcraft. I see them dancing there. The Lord took me to Namibia this day and showed me the big need for repentance, that they too may prepare the way for the coming of the Messiah. Surely the Messiah died for all people, including these communities. Now bringing that to my attention, that a national repentance may be proclaimed forth. I see a hill like this. It's kind of a hill, and they build their huts, their houses, many wives, witchcraft being practiced there. I see many dogs there, small dogs in their homesteads, and children. So the Lord is calling for repentance as he sends me to Namibia. He's calling for a national repentance in Namibia, that there may be a deliberate effort by the church to now harvest the land so that they may prepare for this big revival, to harvest the nation and prepare them for the glorious kingdom of heaven. They too, the Messiah, died for them. Sin is sin. I may be talking the Namibian sin now, but the Kenyan sin is sin. The European sin is also sin. So even as the Lord calls Namibia to repentance, he is also calling all the other nations and all the other people to repentance. The Bible in the book of Acts, chapter 17, verse 30, he says, in the days of old, in the past, God overlooked such ignorance, but now he commands all people everywhere to repent. Why? Because he has now appointed a day when the Messiah would come and judge the nations, take the holy to heaven, and judge those that will have failed to walk in righteousness. Well, the Lord has spoken with me at this moment, at this time, again, about Namibia. And he has, as in the beginning, he spoke with me, as I brought it to you, regarding the villages of Namibia, the great sexual immorality there, the polygamy, the marrying of very young, very, very young girls, and many of them. And also the big witchcraft going on there, the men I see dancing and doing witchcraft. One of them is squatting, I think two or three, squatting one from the back. The others are standing with their elbows folded, doing hands like that, dressed in some traditional thing, their thing. But this time the Lord has spoken with me also about the church in Namibia. He brought me to this place where there is a wedding organized by the church. And I see them wearing creamish, very shiny, shiny clothes, material, shiny and glossy, but slightly creamish, whitish, creamish. And I see a little bit of a tinge of either navy blue or coming a bit little purplish. And the dressing at the wedding, the way that church dresses, the Lord now commands by voice. At this time, the Lord has spoken to me about the church in Namibia also. Then he makes a comment and says, look at the great immorality. So the church, they tie very tight clothes. They want people to see them, the immorality of them, and shiny, very shiny clothes. They're preparing a wedding. I saw them almost like in a line, in a hotel or in a setting or in the church. I don't know which facility this is, but it's a wedding. And the church was wedding. The Lord just spoke this. And I have seen them very shiny cloth, glossy, and sheen, with a sheen. But very, very immorally dressed, immoral, extremely immoral. And then there is another church that I see again, which is close to this other church that is wedding. And I see, I hear this other church saying, but we are better than you. So, because of wealth, this other church looks to be wealthier in terms of the wealth of the earth, money and name it. So again, I see that now. I see that at this time, the Lord has now again spoken with me about the church, but this time the immorality in the church. Because I see this wedding that is taking place. They're preparing, it's about to take place. So then you have this very glossy and shiny cloth, creamish white in color, and the way the ladies are dressed is terrible. It's very tight and immoral and short and with slits and pants and what. So it's absolutely immoral. And so that is now the church preparing for the wedding. But I see a neighboring church, the next church, the Lord brings me here, that is not in a wedding, but the other church knows that this other church is wealthier. This other church also knows it's wealthier than the other church. And so there is a bit of that competition that the Lord raises and highlights between them. And then after that, I see an affluent neighborhood. I think it's a group of townhouses or homes. I see a lot of homes. They're in a straight line, houses or homes, but affluent neighborhood, really affluent. And then a tragedy hits the country, and I see that side of town, that side of residence hit. Houses destroyed totally. The Lord showed me total destruction when Namibia fails to repent. So the Lord has spoken this. And now he's drawn my attention again to the condition of the church in Namibia. And there is big sexual immorality in the church in Namibia and money. It's big money, competition, and the church, there's a conflict in church. Their churches are fighting. They fight one another, and there's also rivalry as in wealth, who is richer than the other. Now, that's very stunning and very disturbing at this hour, when the church should be focusing on the heavenly kingdom that is coming, the kingdom of God, on the heavenly treasure that we behold as a church. And so immorality is in the church that I have seen now. And then there is church fighting. They fight each other because of wealth and name it. And then the dressing of the women is absolutely unacceptable. It's unchristian. In fact, one would wonder, that's why I thought it's a hotel. I wondered whether that's really church for them to dress in that way. And so the Lord has presented this immorality in the land of Namibia. But the church, as you can see, is virtually absent to be able to direct the nation to change the discourse in the land, to articulate righteousness and holiness, and to prepare Namibia for this very wonderful revival that is consuming the hearts of men now and women, and preparing the nations for the coming of the Messiah. So the work is cut out. Namibia is being called unto repentance. The Lord is calling Namibia to repentance, the nation of Namibia. The sin, now the fall that you see in the villages, is out of the shortfall from the house of the Lord. Yeah, now there is a shortfall. There is a need for the house of the Lord to go back to repentance and prepare a vessel for the hour, for the revival of this hour. So I have seen these things in Namibia as I begin my journey to Namibia. The Lord has continued to speak with me about Namibia. That is such a beautiful moment for that country, because the attention of the Lord is focused on that land. That means He really loves Namibia. There are many nations on this earth He could have spoken about, but He's now speaking about Namibia. That means He really, really loves them, and He's crying for their souls and redemption, so that they may enter at this hour when He is preparing the church for entry into heaven and eternity of peace and bliss and blessedness with God. So may those that have ears, even in Kenya, repent, and many nations all the way to Australia. These issues affect the church globally. So this is an hour that when the Lord speaks to a nation, all the other nations and churches take advantage of this and also make amends and go back to righteousness. May the Lord bless Namibia. Shalom.